What's good, everyone? Welcome back to another video on the YouTube channel. This is going to be a slightly different video. It's just going to be raw uncut of me teaching you guys about dealing ranges and how they form, because I know a lot of you struggle with identifying which range you should trade and which range you should not trade. But the main two ranges that I am going to teach you is external ranges and internal ranges, how they form and how you can frame your trades off of. So this video is going to tie in nicely with my free course that I will be launching. So you can get access to the free course in around a week. Just make sure you're inside of my Discord, because that's where I'm going to announce it. So the first range I'm going to teach you is going to be an external range. So this is going to be a swing high and a swing low, or an impulse high or an impulse low, which will create the dealing range. If you've not noted that down already, external ranges form with swing highs and lows, or impulse highs and lows. So here is an example of a market that's trading sideways, and then we have an impulse move to the upside. This is now where your dealing range starts. So the most recent high that we make will be right here. So this becomes the dealing range high, and this low that moved price to the upside, this now becomes your dealing range low. So this is the external low, and this is the external high. Why are we not considering this low as the external low? This is also an external low, but this was the move that made the dealing range to the upside. So this becomes the impulse low, and this becomes the most recent swing high. And price will trade within this dealing range. And if it comes lower and takes out the dealing range low, and then we trade higher, then this is how external liquidity is engineered. So oftentimes you'll see why price doesn't come into this low, because it's not an impulse low and it doesn't need to. It wants to go back into the impulse low that I made to the most recent high, because this is now the external dealing range. And once we take out one side of the external dealing range, we will target the other end. Let's go over an example when we're bearish. This is the market just trading sideways, and then we make a high and then we trade to the downside. So this is now our impulse high, and this now becomes a swing low. And this is where price will trade within the dealing range. And this is our dealing range that we're in. The external high and the external low, and this is our impulse high. So what do I mean by an impulse high and impulse low? This basically means where price reacted aggressively or traded away from this area very strongly. So here we made a high and we just traded to the downside, so this becomes an impulse high. And then a swing low is a three candle low or a three candle high. In this scenario, we have a three candle low, for example. So this is our dealing range low, dealing range high, and this is now our external low, an external high. We wait for the market to take out one side of the external liquidity. So if we take out the external low, we can easily target the external high, and this is where we will TP or take profit within our position for longs. Or if we take out the external high first, then we will target the external low. This is how every high probability is formed, with the understanding of an external high and an external low. And once price runs out one side of the external liquidity, you can target the opposing end. So this is how external dealing ranges form. Let's go over how internal dealing ranges work within external dealing ranges. And this is how internal ranges form within an external range. So we make a swing high right here, and then price trades to the downside, and then we make a swing low. This now becomes our external dealing range, where we have buy side liquidity above this high, and we have sell side liquidity below this low. And now where does the internal dealing range start? Well, if we don't take out sell side liquidity below this low right here, and we don't take out buy side liquidity above this high, once price is trading within this range from this swing high to swing low, this is all internal range. This is where the internal dealing range will form. So we will map out the impulse low. So if this is the low that traded into a fair value gap, for example, and then we traded to the upside, this is now the most recent high. So the dealing range now becomes from this low to this high. So you'll map out your internal dealing range, which is from this impulse low to this most recent swing high. And as we covered before, impulse lows and highs are made once we trade into an area of fair value, or we make a low, trade to the upside or the downside very quickly. So in this case, we rebalance a fair value gap, for example, and then we trade higher. So this becomes a low, this becomes the high. All we do is wait for price to take out one side of this internal dealing range. So if we take out the internal dealing range high, we look for a run to the sell side liquidity of the internal dealing range, and then the run on the external dealing range right here. So once we've taken out the internal high and the internal low, and then we take out the external low right here, what do we look for? We look for price to reverse from here and we look for it to trade back higher into the external, which rests right here, and this was the overall dealing range the market was trading within. So I just showed you guys two ways of how dealing ranges form, where we form with external liquidity and then we form with internal liquidity inside of the external range. You as a trader, you're only looking to trade once we take out the external liquidity. So if we take out the external low, you will target the external high. And if we take out the external high, you will target the external low. Being able to identify this will help your trading a lot, because this is how you know high probability trades are going to form. So looking at your overall dealing range, you focus on external highs and external lows, and they will form with swing highs and swing lows. So this is how your dealing range will form. And within this dealing range, you will have an internal dealing range which forms. This is how the internal dealing range forms, where we fail to take out external liquidity above the swing highs and the swing lows. And then the range which formed within the swing high and swing lows, this will now become your internal dealing range. And this is basically somewhat to an extent how every range forms. And you can find your high probability trades trading only external highs and lows and understanding how they form with internal liquidity. We are going to go over some chart examples right now, but I hope you guys are understanding everything that I am going over. But as always, I will be uploading a flow chart to this on my Twitter page, so make sure you're following that so you don't miss out. Okay, so here I have an example of AUD USD on the 1 hour chart. But what I'm teaching you guys right now, you can apply this to the weekly chart, the daily chart, any time frame you would like. The concept is fractal. It's just understanding how dealing ranges form. And you can see right here, this was our previous dealing range low, and this is what we took out once we traded lower. And then this was our dealing range high, and this is what we took out when we traded high. So what happens now once we take out this dealing range? We took out the high and we took out the low. Well, we have a new dealing range which forms. And where is the new dealing range? Well, it's from this high to this swing low. And what makes this our new dealing range? Well, this is easy because we have a swing low right here. So we have a 3-candle swing low, where this low failed to go below this low, and this low to the right failed to go below the low in the middle. So this was the lowest low that was made. This becomes our swing low. And then if we look right here, this becomes our swing high. So this is the dealing range high, and this is the dealing range low. So what do we do now? We wait for one side of the external liquidity to be taken, because this swing low is external liquidity and this swing high is external liquidity. And as you can see, we failed to take out external liquidity. So now what happens? This low becomes our internal liquidity and this high becomes our internal liquidity. So we wait for the market to take out the internal liquidity high and target the internal liquidity low, take out the external liquidity low, then we can take out the external liquidity high. And the vice versa is done if we take out the external high. And you can see how clear this chart now becomes, because you understand which dealing range you're trading within. Because before, it just looked like candlesticks were everywhere. Like we were trading lower, we were trading higher. But with this understanding, you now know the market is within a range. If it's within a range, why would we try and trade within this range when we can frame a high probability trade if we take out the external liquidity, which rests right here, and then we have an easy area which we can target, which is the external high. And all you do now is let the market print and do its thing, then you can frame your trading setups. And as you can see, we take out the external low. Once we take out the external low, we will move on to a lower time frame, such as the 15-minute or the 5-minute, and wait for a change in the state of delivery. Once we have the change in the state of delivery, the market confirms it wants to trade higher and target the external high. Then we will look for buying setups. But for now, you guys can see that everything I taught you within the internal range, which was this low to this high, price takes out the internal range, then takes out the external range, and now we wait for a high probability setup. So after the 1 hour chart, you can align yourself onto the 15 or 5 minute chart to look for a change in the state of delivery. So on the 15 minute chart, you guys can see that we trade lower, take out the external low, and then we close above these three down close candles. Once we close above these three down close candles, this represents the market is changing the state of delivery and we are going into a buy program. And then the next area that we can look for the market to trade into is in fact the external high, which rests right here. And this is the area that we want to target. So we take out the external low, change the state of delivery, we can target the external high as we're taking out the dealing range low. So after the 15 minute, we will move on to the 5 minute and look for an entry to target the buy side liquidity. So on the 5 minute chart, you can see that we closed above these down closed candles. We had the change in the state of delivery. We took out the external low. What is the area that we are looking at now? We are looking to target the external high and we make a fair value gap right here. So this is an area that we will look to buy because we know the market is going to be bullish and we can put a stop loss below this candle's low because this is the last fair value gap that we filled. And then we will target the external high. So this is a 1-4 trading setup with the understanding of dealing ranges. And as you can see, we trade into the external high and trade into the buy side liquidity. This is exactly how every high probability dealing range and trade forms, with the understanding of external highs and lows and internal range liquidity. So if you use this understanding to your previous losing trades, and if you look back in your journal, you will see that you were trading within a dealing range and you were not waiting for any external liquidity to be taken. So use this understanding to improve your trading and understand how high probability dealing ranges form inside of the market. So I hope you found this video insightful and you learned something new. I will be posting a flowchart on my Twitter page, so make sure you're following that. But I'm going to close off the video here and keep in mind that I'm rooting for you and I hope you find success in this business. As always, have a good rest of your day and thanks for watching.